Let us begin our prayer as one. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Ever hear the expression, what you see is what you get? Yeah, I think if you remember in the early 70s, Flip Wilson might have said it. He was African-American movie star in a TV series. Anyways, what you see is what you get. And that's what kind of alludes to that, that the outside has to match the inside, and the inside has to match the outside, but nothing is hidden. And so let us seek forgiveness when we have hidden many things before the Lord. Lord, give mercy.
Lord, give mercy.
Christ, give mercy.
Christ, give mercy.
Lord, give mercy.
Lord, give mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who brought St. Louis from the cares of earthly rule to the glory of the heavenly realm, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that by fulfilling our duties on earth, we may seek your eternal kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We ask you, brothers and sisters, with regard to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our assembling with him, not to be shaken out of your mind suddenly, or to be alarmed either by his fear or by an oral statement, or by a letter allegedly from us to the effect that the day of the Lord is at hand. Let no one deceive you in any way. To this end, he has also called you through our gospel to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the traditions that you were taught, either by an oral statement or by a letter of ours. May our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting encouragement and good hope through his grace, encourage your hearts and strengthen them in every good deed and word. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord comes to judge the earth. The Lord comes to judge the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the people with equity. The Lord comes to judge the earth. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them. Then shall all the trees of the forest exult. The Lord comes to judge the earth. Before the Lord, for he comes to rule the earth. He shall rule the world with justice and the peoples with his constancy. The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
tithes of mint and dill and cumin, and had neglected the weightier things of the law, judgment and mercy and fidelity. But these you should have done, without neglecting the others. Lion gills, who strain out the nets and swallow the camel. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You cleanse the outside of cup and dish, but inside they are full of plunder and self-indulgence. Lion Pharisees, clean first the inside of the cup, so that the outside also may be clean. The Gospel of the Lord. It's all about being at peace on the inside. You know, I just wonder, you know, you see on TV these people who, you know, kind of go astray in life and they become criminals, the mass murderers, and all this kind of stuff. And I often wonder if it's that from an early age they're just not at peace inside. It just festers, becomes this, you know, emotional infection. It just messes up the mind, the heart, the soul. And so, as people of faith, and especially in celebrating the Eucharist and receiving Jesus in the body of Christ, you know, Lord, help me be at peace on the inside. Help me be clean on the inside. Help me balance that my outside and my inside. There's a balance. What you see is what you get. That you're striving to be clean on the inside and the outside. We have to take care of our bodies on the outside, right? Wash your hair, brush your teeth. We can teach our children that. But we also have to take care of the inside. I don't go to the doctor. I haven't been to the doctor in 4 years. Well, that's silly. We can take care of our insides. And even take pictures of our insides to make sure everything is good. And if not, we're told by medical professionals what we have to do on the inside. And so as we come to receive Eucharist, let us pray that, you know, what you see is what you get, the insides match the outsides match the insides. And as a disciple, we're supposed to pray for one another and help one another. And those who struggle, Lord, how can you use me to help those who are in need this day? There's so much civil unrest. I'm not going to make a judgment call. What I really believe it is people that are hurting inside, and it's just all spewing outside. And sometimes in the right way, and sometimes in the wrong way. Let us pray for all the civil unrest in our country, that people who need to get that peace, that healing inside, may grant it through the help of others. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Let us be mindful of the big world outside before us. The Universal Church, praying for our Pope Francis, praying for all of our leadership throughout the world, that our leaders may help people, you know, on the inside and the outside. For this, let us pray to the Lord. This is a time of harvest, so many farmers are harvesting their crops, so let us pray for an abundant crop. Even we had a very good rain early on, and so Lord, we pray for an abundant crop. We pray that we do better at feeding, especially the poor distribution of food. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Let's always keep in mind our community of faith. May God continue to fill us with the gifts and the graces of stewardship. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Let's be mindful of praying for others, especially our intentions today. Patricia Benton, Afrika, Ashore. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Let us all hold our own petitions within the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Gracious Lord God, hear all of our prayers as we offer them up to Christ our Lord. Amen. which earth has given human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, open of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. We offer in commemoration of blessed St. Louis. Bestow on your faithful, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, during the marvelous confessions of your saints, you make the church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer sure signs of your love. And so, Lord, with the angels and the saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, Lord, and through Christ's resurrection. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, St. Joseph, with the blessed apostles, martyrs, St. Louis, and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, our coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And now let us share with one another a sign of Christmas. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. present in the most holy sacrament.
I love you
above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never be separated from you. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord, in commemoration of Blessed St. Louis, sanctify our minds and hearts, and as we may merit to be made sharers in the divine nature, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The whole lesson in the gospel today was the Pharisees and scribes were making up all the rules, but they didn't follow them. They told everybody else to follow them. And that was the whole point, is, you know, the inside and the outside just don't match. You don't see what you get. So we need to be consistent. We need to be consistent in our belief and our faith. We're striving to balance the inside and the out. That's the lesson of today, of areas being in our insides where we need to heal and grow. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, the Son.